Hello, and welcome by a new episode of the Mirror of Truth. I'm going today in the forest, so you can see. Today, I want to talk about some thing that some people think is beautiful. And the ink that starts to make. And that is skin. Animal skin. Also known as leather, silk, fur, something like that. My definition, wearing of skin of another animal, but not natural, belongs to you. Have nothing to do with any status symbol of what you have. Some people believe that wearing of fur is one beautiful thing. I say that people have the same kind of understanding from what is beautiful. The people that skin juice and make lamp caps from it, and World War II from the Nazis. Nazis have done with the Jews. There is absolutely no beautifulness in the fur industry. Animals being animal executed, put on a metal object in the vagina of the ends of the animals, and electrocute them from inside out. Let them chew on electro stuff so that they can electrocute. Also, a lot of time they've been skinned alive, and then the bodies in, still moving after the skinning. Also, the animals in the fur industry been put in small cages, but they become get a neurotic behavior, just like people that been in prison also gets a lot of times in Chinese prisons and that kind of prisons, extremely small prison cells. That's the prison cells what we have in the Netherlands, because that's in the eyes of a Chinese prisoners a 5-star hospital, according to many media. Cannot even move. They jump from side to side like this, and do other things. From stress and all kinds of anxiety that are get in these places, from being commodified and exploited. Fur is not beautiful in reality. It's also barbaric and absolutely necessary. You have today many forms of fake fur if you want truly to have something the same kind of aesthetics. Or don't wear it at all. There been a lot of other materials that you can use to show the difference. Just like with silk. Silk is actually made in most cases from the flu it from silk. And that being kind of warms you. It's being come actually from working from China, so there I know. And they are being actually farmed for their silk. They are being first. They are being breathed. Then their skin, their larvae, and in the larvae, and then become pups, and they take actually the purple of the worms from it, and that makes an silk. It's from the spinning of their cotton worms, as you know, this section. I have a link in the description below if you want to know that in more detail. Maybe I want to do a whole video explaining that whole topic as well. Most people also think that leather, for example, topic number 3, is a byproduct from the meat, the Aryan egg industry, from the flesh industry, from the breastfeeding of cow industry, and the chicken curios industry. So I like the quote. But in reality, the whole animal's cow skin and other leathers, also dog skin sometimes, and there is no way to 100% sure know if you product me from dog skin cow skin, and if you know the manufacturer, then you can be sure. Actually, the whole industry is a whole industry on its own. It is a $1 billion industry that can actually subsidize themselves. What amount it's produced. Think for a moment about how much shoes cost, and from a third nation was actually. And they're being always used some kinds of toxic environment polluted. Materials, and chemicals to let the animal skin not actually not sent to tanneries that use deadly substances rot away toxins to stop decomposition, and still sterilize that for leather is dead flesh. The way it lets me look how most skin actually comes. A lot of come from the Muslim communities in and the Christian communities in India, because in most of the places where the Hindus live, they are actually don't murder cows. Streets, and actually the skin of the animals, they've been actually also skinned alive. I put it with one scholar knife over the skin, over the bodies of the animals, and then they're actually they're filtering actually the animals to that. The skin, leather come there. They're stroking the skin of the animals, and they put that in chemical chemical beds, so that they don't rot away. Then the all these chemicals we put in the waterway, so it pollutes their water, and come also on the end of this whole process into the sea. But also kills a lot of marine species, make also a lot of humans sick. To die from all the chemicals that have been dropped in the water. Water drink. Any cigarettes, anything in the whole world have a reason why it worked this way. There's one system, one infallible system. Not one system like humans, like a human system. Like one group thinks they're more special than another and discriminate without reason, without thinking. Humans can actually learn still a lot from other species and from nature in his home. About altruism, about rationality, about being not prisoner of their own cognitive dissonance. They're all matrix. One thing that I think people have to learn in this age is to learn to think for yourself. If you go by the habit to listen to what other bodies say about some topic and don't figure it out for yourself, you find out that your state, your government, your family members, in your so-called social order, let you hide the victims and let you love the victimizers. No, it's good to have a wide open vision and what I have to say. But when it comes to make a decision, you have to put all the trash out and place it to where it belongs. Don't wear animal skins. Animal skins don't belong to humans. Animal skins belong to the animals where they are being born with. How will you feel if somebody skinned your life and turned out and turned you in one commodity, make a jacket out of human skin and sell that to cannibals? Because they don't care about human life, so they can wear human skin. Why die lodging? How can you ask for something? Mercy. When you're not being willing to receive this. And extend it. To all innocent liberties in nature. Nature is not the great bad guy that most humans want to let it look. Yes, nature can look in some aspects dark and evil. But also, it also gives a lot of beautiful stuff. You have not to be so blind. What's the excuse for the last time? For causing the least amount of harm possible on the planet. We have today a lot of vegan imitation skins. Like the shoes that I wear now. From vegetarian shoes. There's a company that makes 100% only vegan shoes. And you have also, if you like gothic style shoes, We have demonia. Demonia are around something like 60% of their shoes being from plant material, being vegan shoes. They're being not leathers. At least 60% of their shoes being not leather. And that stands all up on other websites actually. Maybe the stats have been high, but at least 60%. There have been also shoes companies like New Balance, and also there have been also a lot of other companies. So do your research. I've also put some links in the description below. And so, go vegan.
Go just being safe.
What's the excuse for costing the least amount of harm possible on the planet? Always being vegan. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinter away and the true become visible. I see you next time.
For leather comes primarily from